Hello and welcome back to my channel. Today's problem is Samsung Galaxy S8 Plus that either won't turn on at all or display all sorts of messages, probably after you flash something you shouldn't have. The exact reason why this phone is dead is because I followed routing instructions of this guy, who by the way guided me through the entire process of getting this phone back to life. So all the things and love and hate should be going to him and not me. I'm just a middle guy trying to solve everybody's problems. If your phone can boot to download mode and connects to PC, then you don't need to take the phone apart. If download mode starts but the phone does not connect to PC, boot to recovery and select option reboot to bootloader. This will start download mode and it will connect to PC, you'll be able to flash your phone. If your phone is booting up to a weird screen with the serial number or BOTA screen, look at the screen and watch for Secure Download Enable. If you see it, that means you can flash your phone without taking it apart. But if your phone is completely dead and does not make any connection to the PC no matter what you do, stay tuned. First, we need to heat up and remove the back cover. The suction cup spreader I use in this video works really well. I highly recommend you getting one of those if you do this kind of work. Then remove SIM card tray and continue with the screws. Then you have these plastic covers you need to carefully pry out of the way, exposing the battery and the main board. Few more screws under the cover and you're ready to start prying the board out of the frame. Start from the top of the phone, disconnecting the battery, rear camera and display ribbons, gently pry the board out of the frame as shown here. On the opposite side of the board, we need to heat up and gently remove this aluminum tape without damaging it. Use something sharp like a razor blade to separate it from the shield. Clean up what's left so you can see the gap between the two metal shields. Position the board in front of you with the exposed gap facing you. To help us find what we need, we will use this schematic, which I will link in the description. I will look at the pad number 3, left of the capacitor, on the top row. Pad is labeled TP6005. So if I search for TP6005, shows that it is connected to the chip, UFS reset pin. Next step is to put your PC into test mode. Google that. Reboot, install the drivers and reboot again. With the computer in test mode and drivers installed, we first need to connect the cable to the phone first before we attempt to make a stunt. Using my right hand, holding the needle, gently press against the metal shield. I will poke that needle into the pad, effectively jumping the pad to the ground. At the same time, with my left hand, I will connect the USB cable to the PC. And if PC is making the connection sound, we're good to go. Otherwise, try again. To verify that we're ready, open the device manager and look under COM devices. There you should see Qualcomm device. Run the supply script and enter correct COM number that should match what the device manager shows. Hit enter and let it flash. Warning! If you did not receive Sahara Hello, that means your phone bootloader version is 8. At the time of this video, only version 7 is supported. That means your phone is done, sell it for parts. Now we can put the board back in the frame, but this time I'll use only 3 screws so we can test everything before we close it completely. These screws require for the phone buttons to work and to have a good USB connection. Now that we have the phone ready, we put it into download mode as usual and flash stock firmware. And that should be it for now. I hope you find this video helpful. Thank you for watching and have a blessed day. Bye bye.